All right, for this video, we're going to continue with our previous example. We have the exact same two-step mechanism, and now we're going to get into more detail where we discuss rate laws. And as a quick review to illustrate some points in here, we do want to know our overall equation. So again, we're canceling out the NO2 and the NO3s. So our overall equation is this. Our next step is to be able to write the rate law for each elementary step. And again, to do that, we're going by the original equation without crossing anything out. So remember, for elementary steps, rate laws are written with the coefficient as the order of a reactant. And again, this is because we know as we change the concentration of a reactant for an elementary step, we know how the rate of that step will be affected. Recognize this is not true for overall reactions. This is only true for elementary steps. This is a very key point to recognize. And so for step one, our rate law will be rate equals. Remember, we always start with the rate constant. And NO2, we have a coefficient of 2, so that is second order. For step two, its rate law will be the rate equals rate constant times the concentration of NO3 is going to be first order, and CO is also going to be first order. Recognize those ones are optional, just illustrating the point that our coefficient is our order here. So now the key is to put all of this information together to identify the rate law for the overall reaction. The other key piece we need to recognize is, of course, our rate determining step. So again, a rate determining step is the slow step, and it's the one that will determine the rate of the overall reaction. So the analogy that I always use is pretend our class is going to take a road trip up to Payson. And we reach that part in the drive where it goes down to two lanes. It's that windy, twisty road. And we're all driving separately just because we're crazy. And as we reach this point in the road or on the drive where we reach the two-lane road, twisty, windy, some old guy pulls out in the middle of our caravan. And we know that they don't drive very fast. Okay, maybe old woman. I don't know. Somebody who doesn't drive fast. So they pull out in the middle of our caravan and they slow the entire caravan down. And our road or our trip can't start until everybody gets there. And the same idea happens with the slow step in a mechanism. It will determine the speed of the overall reaction. The whole reaction can't happen any faster than that slow step. Well, it turns out that since step one is our slow step here, and we know the rate of it by this rate law, that when our first step is the slow step, or the rate determining step, RDS, its rate law, the rate law of the first step, will be the rate law for the overall. And so, in other words, the rate law for our overall equation will be rate equals K times the concentration of NO2 squared. So, something important that I want to point out here, again, rewriting our rate laws next to each equation so we can see them. Right? Elementary step coefficient is the order. Elementary step coefficient is the order of each reactant. But notice for the overall equation, the coefficient does not match the order of the substance, right? Based on this definition down here, that when the first step is slow, its rate law is the rate law for the overall. In other words, these two are exactly the same. But notice that the coefficients for my overall equation do not match the orders that we're reporting in our rate law. That is only true for elementary steps. So very, very key definitions here that are illustrated on our next slide. So the red ink means that it's very important. Again, when we're writing rate laws for elementary steps, the coefficients are the orders of the reactants. This is not the case for the overall reaction. To determine the rate law for an overall reaction, we either have to use rate and concentration data, remember our rate laws section earlier in this chapter, or we have to use information from our reaction mechanisms and the rate determining step. So we cannot use coefficients to determine the orders for our overall reaction. Again, very important point. If the first step of a reaction is slow, that rate law of the first step is the rate law of the overall equation. So the other implication here is if the rate law for the overall equation does not match the rate law for the first step, then we know the first step is not the slow step. We'll see an example of that in our next video.